Guys, I want to welcome you back to the channel. This is the Digital Review. I am your host, Mike. And in this video, we're going to talk about the NBA free agents, the two most important NBA free agents. I know who you're thinking. You're thinking Kawhi. You're thinking Kevin Durant. But that is not true. Part of it's not true. And I'll be back in 1 second to tell you all about it. So everyone's talking about Kevin Durant, Kyrie Irving, Kawhi Leonard, Kemba Walker, the 4Ks, Jimmy Butler. And I'm here to tell you, there are two guys in particular that are really going to determine what happens in the NBA for the next 3 to 4 years, depending on how long they sign and where they go. You know, everybody's talking about Kyrie and Kevin Durant. Let's just start with Kevin Durant. If Kevin Durant goes to the Knicks, he better win. He better bring a co-star, number one. If he goes to the Nets, that's probably a better move. They probably will win some games. There won't be as much pressure on him to win the title. He won't have all that New York Knicks history on his back to deal with. He won't have to worry about bringing a co-star. But let's just say Kevin Durant decides to go to the Knicks with Kyrie. The East is back balanced because he's no longer in Golden State. Everybody's got two All-Stars minus the Lakers. And that leaves my guy, Jimmy Butler, signing where? If I'm Jimmy Butler, I'm looking at where everyone's signing before I signed anything, because Jimmy Butler could fit right in perfectly in Golden State, and we got 4 or 5 more years of dynasty going on. Nobody's ever thought about that. Kawhi Leonard could fit right in with Golden State, especially after he beats them for a title. He could fit right in with Golden State, and we got 4 or 5 years more of a dynasty. Jimmy Butler could go fit in with the Lakers with the current squad they have, and they don't have to screw up their cap space by trading Lonzo Ball for Bradley Beal, who has a high salary. They don't even have to do that. They can keep Lonzo Ball. They can keep all the young kids. They can keep their draft pick. They can use their draft pick and someone else for a trade. Have Jimmy Butler, and they are right there in the playoff thing. Jimmy Butler could go to Houston, and Houston is now the favorite in the West without KD at Golden State. So if I'm Jimmy Butler, I'm sitting there thinking, I might not stay here in Philly, because to me that fit really didn't fit him. It didn't fit his play style. I don't know if the coach didn't drive with him, if Embiid didn't drive with him. I don't know what that was about, but to me, I don't stay there. Jimmy Butler could go anywhere besides Philly and Boston, and anybody who's got a major team, whether that be Houston, LA, Golden State, Toronto, the Nets, any one of those five squads would be playoffs, and a couple of them will be championship contenders with Jimmy Butler. His game translates. He's long. He's athletic. He plays. I've seen the guy play in person. He plays bigger than 6'6", 6'8". He's just long. He's just big and up close. When you see him up close, the guy's big. He plays smart basketball. He hits difficult shots. He can shoot the three. He can put the ball on the floor. He can finish at the rim. He can defend 1 through 5. One through three. Why would you not want this guy in your squad? Forget all the other stuff, the head case stuff or the hard to coach stuff. Put him somewhere where you got a strong coach, a strong coaching system, or a strong, you know, leader like LeBron, like Golden State, places like that, and you're gonna be fine. I think if we went on that criteria, I wouldn't want him in Houston, because they clearly don't have a strong coach, and Chris Paul may not be there after some of the rumors that I heard about him being traded. You know, but again, to me, Jimmy Butler and Kawhi Leonard are the most important free agents. Klay is not going anywhere, but you know what? If you put Klay on the Lakers, they're not winning the title. You guys need to get over that. If you put Kemba Walker on the Lakers, you're not winning the title. Get over that. If you put Jimmy Butler on the Lakers, they're not winning the title, but they are in the Western Conference Finals. They beat Denver. They beat Portland. They beat Houston, point blank. So, if I'm that guy, Jimmy Butler, and I'm sitting here pointing where I want to live at, L.A. looks real good right about now. You know what? You'll be poised to be the star of the team in about 3 years. You're still young, and hey, why not? Brooklyn looks really good, especially alongside Kevin Durant, if they can pull that off. Looks better than New York. You know, New York's got the number 3 pick. If you go to New York with KD, I'd let KD sign first, but with you, KD, and R.J. Barrett, that's a nice little squad in New York. Anywhere Jimmy Butler goes after the big two sign, there could be a title coming with him. So that is my opinion. on the most important two NBA free agents this offseason. We'll find out in about a month where everything goes. People sign July 1st, straight down NBA deadline. And if you got an opinion, I would love to hear what you think. Hit me up in the comment section. Hit that like button if you like what you heard. Subscribe. Help me out. Help me get to 1,000. Help me get to 100 views on this video. And as always, I'll see you in the next video.